Hi, this is Gary with macmost.com. On today's episode, instead of focusing on some of the big new features of macOS Sierra, let's take a look at some of the little things, the tiny additions that may be useful to you. So let's start off by looking at a very tiny change in the Finder that a lot of people are going to really like. Here I'm looking at a list of documents and folders inside of a folder. And what a lot of people want is to be able to separate the folders from the files but not go to the extreme of arranging everything by kind. Well, you now can go into Finder Preferences and under Advanced you can select Keep Folders on Top when sorting by name. And now the folders are first and the files are after it. Now while Picture and Picture Video is very useful on iOS, on Mac we've always had windows, so we could be looking at a video like this online, we could shrink the window down and do other work at the same time. But we have true picture in picture ability now. When you're viewing a video in Safari, and it works in iTunes as well, you'll get this picture in picture button here. It only works if the video is just basic H.264 video presented in the web browser. If you're looking at a special interface like YouTube presents, you may not see this button, so it's not going to work everywhere. But when you click it, you get a little picture-in-picture window that you can move around to each corner. You can even drag the edges, make it a little smaller. You can take it back into the app that you're in. You can hit a play button, and then of course you can we can hide Safari here completely, and the video still stays. So I can launch another app and do something else, and I can put the video in any corner that I want. And continue to watch it. Anytime I want to jump back to Safari, I hit this button and it brings Safari up again and puts the video back. So on Macs we're typing with real keyboards, but on an iPad or iPhone we're using virtual keyboards, and we get a little cool thing where at the end of a sentence you can, instead of hitting period and then space, you can do two spaces and then get a period. Well, you can have that now too on a Mac if you go into System Preferences, under Keyboard, Text, turn on Add Period with Double Space. And now you get the period when you hit the space bar twice. Unfortunately, the Messages app doesn't get all the cool bells and whistles that you get in iOS. But there are a couple things that you get. The first is you get big emoji. And what does that mean? Well, if you type a regular text message and you add emoji to it, nothing changes. It's the same. But if you only include emoji and no regular text, the emoji is sent as big. Now one feature Macs do get from iOS is the ability to use Tapback, which simply allows you to respond to a message like this with a quick action. So I'm going to click and hold and you get these icons here, and you can just respond with one or more of them. So they're simple things like a thumbs up, and then it appears like this, and that's how the person who sent it to you also sees it. So you can do that. You can also control click and you get a tap back option there as well. Now here's something that's going to make lots of people happy. Have you ever wanted to rearrange these icons here at the top but been frustrated because some allow you to move them and some don't? Well, now you can move almost all of them. So of course you can move the third party ones, and you can do that using the command key and then dragging, and you can drag them in any order you want. And you can use the default ones like Time Machine and the Wi-Fi there. You can even use the user there, even Spotlight, and even Siri. Can't move notifications though. That's always going to be in the upper right. Now like many, I've always hated that the default text size in Notes is pretty small, and while you can change it, a new note, you just have to change it all over again. But now you've actually got a preference here for the default text size, so you can set it to be bigger, and then when you create a new note, it's automatically big.
There is one more I want to mention, but it's kind of hard to demonstrate. It's the shared clipboard. So if you have multiple Macs or maybe an iPad and an iPhone and they're all logged in using the same Apple ID, if you copy on one device, say a piece of text or even an image, and immediately paste on another device, you'll paste from across the devices. That's a little imperfect when I tried it out because of course you have to wait a second or two for the copy to be realized on the other machine. And also, it expires after some time. So if you copy something on your iPad and then later on that day you sit down on your MacBook, you're not suddenly going to be surprised about what's in the clipboard. It only lasts about 2 minutes or so. But still, it's going to be a useful feature for a lot of people, especially when you want to transfer that critical little piece of text from one device to another.